Give it up for BRUXES!
Maybe someday we'll hold them up to me.
We're talking with Rachel from the amazing group BRUXES. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fantastic. Okay, first question. Tell us about the name BRUXES.
Sure. So bruxing is like the clenching and grinding of teeth. It's most commonly an anxiety thing. So I'm a highly anxious person. It's something that I tend to do in my sleep. I wake up with headaches a lot. So I wanted the band name to be something, you know, tied to the subject matter of the music. A lot of it has to do with, you know, my personal experiences, mental health, my anxiety. So I wanted to, you know, keep it very personal, very close to the subject matter of the music. So I decided to go with BRUXES.
Tell me how the band came together.
Sure. So I have actually been playing music with various combinations of the guys I currently play music with for about 10 years in different bands. We all kind of met up through the local Triangle music scene. I started playing these songs that are on the BRUXES EP out as a solo act in 2013 and 2014. And the guys actually kind of have volunteered over the years to help me put full band versions of those songs together. So, you know, finally in 2015, I was able to take them up on that offer.
So what have been some of your musical influences?
That's a great question. So one of my personal biggest influences would be Kate Bush. She's fantastic. She's so creative and unique. I really enjoy the production of all her various records and how deeply personal her music is. I know the guys and I are all influenced a lot by 80s music, bands like The Cure, The Smiths. We are also highly influenced by a lot of like 90s indie rock. I know some of us are very influenced by Fugazi, a lot of great Triangle bands like Superchunk and Archers of Loaf that might not come across in our music, but you know, all of those bands are very important to us.
On your Facebook page, yes. You describe your music as tummy hurt. What does that mean?
Well, tummy hurt is the nickname that was given to me by our drummer, Griffin. I got the nickname tummy hurt because I have a really dumb sense of humor. So anytime I make Griffin laugh, he likes to say that his tummy hurts when it happens. So now he has just started calling me tummy hurt over this past year. I really don't want to take my music too seriously. I don't like when bands, you know, put a lot of thought into what genre they are and are pigeonholed, you know, themselves into the type of music they make. So I wanted to be silly with our description.
So if there was only one word to describe Raleigh and the music scene here, what would that word be?
I would go with diverse. There's a lot of great stuff going on. I mean, there's an active, you know, Americana and country scene. There's a really great hip hop community in Raleigh. There's a lot of great indie rock. I don't really think of one type of music when I think about Raleigh. I think of all sorts.
What would be any advice you could give any artist out there wanting to start?
Just do it. There's never a perfect time to start making music. You'll never feel ready. You'll never feel prepared for it. You get better at making music by going out there and embarrassing yourself and making mistakes and learning from them. So you just gotta start.
Last question.
Yes.
What's a really cool place in Raleigh?
One of my favorite places to go is I take my dog hiking at Umstead a lot. I love going there to just kind of unplug from the world. You know, if you get out there during a weekday when the weather is nice, you don't run into too many people. It gets kind of crowded on the weekends because everyone gets the same idea, but I really love Umstead.